Lord, I see an island.
My loyal friends, stay here, the rest of you, while with my boat and crew, I go to check who these men are. Find out if they are wild, lawless aggressors, or the type to welcome strangers and fear the gods. Dear Cyclops, we are Greeks here from Troy. The wind has swept us off in all directions across the vast expanse of the sea. Off course from our planned route back home.
I am not afraid of the gods. I am almighty Polyphemus. Now why have you come here?
Poseidon the Earthshaker shipwrecked me at the far end of your island. He pushed us in, wind dashes on the rocks. We barely managed to survive. O Polyphemus, because of your greatness and handsomeness, I will give you wine from the gods themselves.
Another. Now please tell me your name, so I can give you a present as my guest, one you will like.
My name is No Man.
I will eat no man last. First, I will eat the other men. That is my gift to you.
Polyphemus becomes drunk and falls asleep. Odysseus then stuck a spear into the eye of the Cyclops and blinded him. Odysseus then tied himself and all of his men to the bottom of the rams. When the Cyclops took his rams outside, Odysseus untied himself and his crew and ran to his ship. Proud of his great feat, Odysseus yelled at Polyphemus.
Hey you, Cyclops! Idiot! The crew trapped in your cave did not belong to some poor weakling. Well, you had it coming. You had no shame in eating your own guests, so Zeus and the other gods have paid you back. If any mortal asks you how your eye was mutilated and made blind, say that Odysseus, the city sacker, Laertes' son, who lives in Ithaca, destroyed your sight.
Listen, Earthshaker, blue-haired Poseidon, acknowledge me, your son, and be my father. Grant that Odysseus, the city sacker, will never go back home. Or if it is fated that he will see his family, then let him get there late and with no honor, in pain and lacking ships and having caused the death of all his men. And let him find trouble, more trouble, in his own house. My lord, I see another island. Should we go to it? The last few have been so dangerous.
I climbed the rocks to a higher ground to look around. This is an island, wreathed about by boundless sea. The land lies low. I saw smoke in the middle, rising through the forest and thick bush. As we all know, the hero who has come under the protection of the Cosmic Mother cannot be harmed.
They stood outside and heard some lovely singing. It was Circe, the goddess. She was weaving as she sang, an intricate, enchanting piece of work, the kind a goddess fashions. She led them in, sat them on chairs, and blended them a potion of barley, cheese, and golden honey, mixed with Pramian wine. Then she struck them using her magic wand and penned them in the pixie. They were turned to pigs in body and voice and hair. Their minds remained the same. He stood there at the doorway and saw her, the lovely Circe, with her braided hair. She hoped to do him harm. She struck him with her wand, but Odysseus drew his sword and lunged at him.
Who are you? Where is your city? And who are your parents? I am amazed that you could drink my potion and yet not be bewitched. Now sheathe your sword and come to bed with me. Through making love, we may begin to trust each other more.
Majestic Lady Circe walked among them, anointing each one with some new drug. The potion had made thick hog hairs spread on their bodies. Their bristles all flew off, and they were men, but younger than before, and much more handsome and taller. Odysseus and his men sailed away from this treacherous island, with his crew and his life. On the way to Ithaca, Odysseus was cursed, and all of his men died. When he was holding on his dear life, Calypso saved him and brought him in to her island. She promised him immortality if he married her.
Zeus orders you to send him on his way at once, since it is not his destiny to die here, far away from those he loves. It is his fate to see his family and come back home to his own native land.
You cruel, jealous gods, you bear a grudge whenever any goddess takes a man to sleep with as a lover in her bed.
Zeus has commanded you to let Odysseus go back home. Send him now, avoid the wrath of Zeus. Do not enrage him, or one day his rage will hurt you.
Goddess, you have some other scheme in mind, not my safe passage. You are telling me to cross this vast and terrifying gulf in just a raft, when even stable schooners fed on winds from Zeus could not succeed.
By the sky above and by the waters of the Styx below, which is the strongest oath for the blessed gods, I swear I will not put any more pain for you.
On the raft, she put a flask of wine, a bigger flask of water, and a large supply of food. She sent him off with gentle, lukewarm breezes. Odysseus arrived in Ithaca, disguised as a homeless man. When Odysseus arrived at home, he found the suitors wasting his wealth on feasts. Each night and day, they butcher sheep, not one but dozens of them, and pour out yet more wine for their reckless drinking. When he went there, they harmed him and made him fight another evil homeless person. So when Penelope arranged an archery competition to win her hand in marriage, he joined and won easily. He then revealed his identity as Odysseus, and they turned and killed all their suitors along with Telemachus.
My friends, they want to slaughter us and strip our arms. Avenge my former wrong, save your lives. Now shoot!
He was finally able to rest from his long, hard journey.